This is a gorgeous stretch of street. It might actually be really good for some panning shots. I am pretty happy with those. I love taking panning shots on this camera. It's amazing. Shame I was a bit too close to that Ferrari, but there was a wall behind me and I couldn't get any further back. Hello, hello, and welcome to a very moody day in London. Today's loose plan is to walk along the canal and take photos of stuff. That's as far as I got with my thinking. We are shooting again today with an upside down X100V. The GoPro is holstered and ready to go, and let's just start. Before we start wandering down the canal, we're gonna have a little wander around at the coal drops yard first. There's some brilliant buildings here, and looking down all the alleyways, there's loads of cool framing shots, and you can see all the cranes and the buildings. Very cool. Ooh, Eurostar train. When the world's a bit back open again, I really want to do like a day trip from here to Paris to do a POV. If anybody's interested, send me a DM on Instagram. You've got all of the cool stuff downstairs, as well as all of these flowers upstairs. This place is just amazing. These are going to be some angry edits today. Anywho, back to walking along the canal. I just can't resist these grey buildings against the moody sky. It's too cool. A couple of weeks ago, I was down here with someone taking photos for their Instagram, and there was a cool puddle here. I think the photo came out pretty cool. If you want to see some more of them, head over to Ryan's Instagram. I'll link it in the description below. This is a kind of interesting shot. You've got the nice flower in the middle here. You've got the building in the background and the reflection of the building on the canal. I kind of like it. There are always cool buildings along canals. I wonder if it's a rule. If you're building next to a canal, your building must be cool. I've already taken a picture of this Mike Wazowski street art for my Instagram, but I love it and I need to take a photo of it every time I see it. I like the framing here with this crane tucked in the middle here. It's very pleasing to my frame-driven brain. Side note, what is going on with the weather? Why is grey then blue again, then grey again? Help! I really like this reflection. That's a proper nice little slice of London. Yet another brilliant example of really awesome looking canal side architecture. Hello, little moorhen. No, you don't want your photo taken. That's okay. More cool canal side architecture. Yes, please. The next place you get to along this walk is Camden. Now, it's a little bit early for everything to be open, so we're not going to explore just yet. But if you are following this walk along, I really recommend stopping off here and getting something to eat. There are so many cool things. The sun really hits these buildings in the most gorgeous way, doesn't it? Well, it's cool street art and it's a good message. I don't know what more you want. I really like the way the light is hitting this wall here between the bridges. So I'm just gonna wait for like a cyclist or someone to come past so I can get a really cool snap of them. Look at this gorgeous little corner building. That's awesome. What a smashing view. What a great little walk this is. So the little gray boat going past me is a go boat. And you can actually rent these out further up the canal. I've never actually done it because I don't have enough friends. There are a lot of points along this walk where you can duck off of the path and up onto a bridge to have a cool look at the canal. This isn't one of those points, but I reckon I can fit through the fence. I was right. And while we're up here, why not take a photo of this cool building tucked neatly between these trees? I'm not all that far off the path I was just walking on, but it's just an incredibly different view. And there's a go boat coming that I'm going to wait for because it might make a nice photo between these railings. So many boats, so little time. I don't know what this building is. All I know is that it looks amazing between these trees on top of that hill. Another evil looking building lurking in the background. That looks absolutely lovely perched there, doesn't it? Well, I can't go any further this way, so I have to go up onto the bridge. I'm sure that the excavator boat is a perfectly normal part of canal maintenance, but look how awesome it is. That is a very industrial view over there in the distance, which is a very stark contrast to what we've seen so far on this canal walk. I definitely was following the canal, but then I went up a ramp and now I'm on a street. I'm confused. Google Maps, help! It looks like the water is onto this street ahead and then turn right. Yeah, we'll see. In the meantime, let's take some photos of some cool building. That building nested on the other buildings looks even cooler. I'm not entirely sure where I am, but there are some absolutely gorgeous buildings here. I found the most awkwardly pathed path in the world. I have found the canal again, it's just over there and I'm not allowed down there because they don't own a boat. I love that little swan-shaped planter, that's really cute. And here we are at the next stop along our walk, Little Venice. I presume it's called that because of all the boats, but I could be wrong. Actually, it's probably more likely that it's all the water, isn't it? The waterside cafe Little Venice. Doesn't that look and sound perfect for a relax? Now, this is by no means a full exploration of the canals. There are literally miles and miles and miles that I have ignored. Nearly got caught by another pigeon. But the canal walk that we have done today is a nice little shortish walk that you can do as part of any other day out. If you're doing this as part of a day trip as well, one of the best things about this walk is that it drops you off right at Paddington Station, where you can then connect to anywhere else in central London. Ah yes, the famous Paddington bubble bath. Rainbow coloured, reflective and shiny. Is this made for me? Let's see if we can get some cool views up on this bridge. That is a super interesting set of buildings. What's it even covered in? That's so cool. This frame here might make a cool panning shot for like a double-decker bus or something. Let's see what we can find. I've just poked my head away from the canal for a bit just to have a look at some of these buildings because this is so much glass. Whoa, look at that blue. That is awesome. Look at that building. Framed so nicely for me right between those two other buildings. The clouds reflected in this pointy building look so amazing. Going for a rare landscape shot now of what I thought was one really long boat, but actually looks like it's two boats stuck together. Tall buildings tucked between taller buildings. It doesn't really get much more London than that, does it? There's something really cool about seeing these massive construction sites on London's skyline, but there's something even cooler about wrapping them in leaves. Unfortunately, I have now run out of time for this walk, so I'm going to start heading to the train station and just taking snaps of things I can see along the way, like this really cool apartment building. It's no wonder I'm always late. I'm so easily distracted. Look at this bridge. If you're on this bridge, you kind of have to stop in the middle and turn left and take a photo of that, because look how cool that set of buildings is at the end. I love anything that lets me walk across wooden planks. I'm all about the wooden plank life. Have we got time for a mirror selfie? Yeah. Thank you so much for joining me on this walk from London King's Cross to London Paddington via the canal. It's a fantastic way to spend a few hours. There's cafes and flowers and all sorts of other pretty things. But for now, it is time to go home, which is where I already am. That walk in London is lovely. I really do enjoy walks like that where it's just nice and calm. You just wander along and you take photos of the things that are pretty. Thank you very much for joining me on this walk. I hope you enjoyed watching it as much as I enjoyed doing it and making it. And I will see you next time. Thank you again for watching. I really do hope you enjoyed that video. Let me know what you thought in the comments. And if there's anywhere that you want to see me go, also let me know. Also in the comments.